Cole, can you start for me first? Yep.
My name is Jessica Rudland.
Bianca, can you read me your sentence?
And I am a teacher at Peel Language Development Primary School in Port Kennedy, south from Perth.
Good. Bailey.
I'm at six.
Yep. The school is a language inclusive school, so we deal with different types of language abilities, and students come to this school because they have a delay in one of the areas of language.
Guys, great reading.
There are six areas in
Stop
language.
Now and get on with our sight words.
So I have got planned a lesson which is basically a recount.
Okay, had.
Recalling on their semantic knowledge, which is your word bank. Around.
You've turned it into an air. That's alright.
And then we're going to brainstorm and come up with some keywords, and then these keywords will be used to create sentences.
If you keep learning your words, then you can get some more ones. Good boy.
We're learning about sharks, and when we introduce a new animal, it's always very exciting because we do the things to make it exciting. We do a craft or we do an animal description. We engage them in the learning.
Which animal will is a fish? That moves its tail from side to side.
Some kids are very overstimulated with the environment.
Unlike whales.
And it's about centering them and getting them to sit on the ground to start with. Once they have mastered sitting on the ground, then we might work on things like keeping your hands and feet to yourself.
Noah, you're a beautiful whale.
Sitting up straight. And once they have got this, then we're ready to start our learning.
Sit down, Riley. Cross your legs. How many teeth do sharks have?
Basically, from the first day, the students need to know that I'm here to support them.
Give it a go, Jack. I just read it. How many teeth do sharks have? 3,000.
And because it is a smaller classroom, we're able to give the kids much more time and valuable feedback.
Would you like a friend to help you, Jack?
Yes.
Choose a friend, please.
Engage them in the learning.
3,000.
And encourage them to make mistakes and learn from these mistakes. I am a confident teacher, so if I present confidence and if the kids understand I know what I'm talking about, then they're going to feel positive about what they're learning.
On the count of three, where do you find a shark?
One, two, three.
And they're also going to understand what they're learning because they know it's come from a valuable source.
Okay, we are going to write ocean.
The reason I've planned this lesson is because I feel like it can be adapted and changed in a variety of ways.
Which one you would like into a sentence?
Ocean.
Sea and ocean. Special features. What have you learned that is a special feature, Jack?
The shark's older than dinosaurs.
The shark is older than dinosaurs. Well done.
When I'm planning for a lesson or an assessment, I can have a look at the students' goals and then target them towards the Australian curriculum as well and incorporate them into the lesson and the outcomes I'd like achieved. The kids are grouped on their ability levels, and these ability levels are all formed from the testing. So, for example, within the square group, I would expect the students to be able to form two sentences with some grammatical indicators in those sentences.
And then on the board we've got ocean.
Every day we do a recount or we do a piece of writing.
You can write sea or ocean, you can choose.
I wouldn't do an activity that is too hard for a student. I believe that all students need to have a success and achievement.
The ocean. Good talking.
That they can actually work with each other in a group. They can support and they can scaffold their learning with each other. So you get some kids that are very independent and want to help other children learn in the classroom, and it's a fantastic way to scaffold the learning. And the way we instill independence in them is by giving them a routine. We have book helpers, we have desk chair stackers, we have cleaners. So the kids are really inquisitive and they want a job and they want to be able to help. I think in the first year it was just about getting through that year for myself. And now I think it's more about looking at how far they've come, and it's very exciting.
3,000
million teeth.
Teeth.